The hormone gastrin is released from the antrum of the stomach. In the antrum, actually there are certain cells known as G cells which release the gastrin hormone. And as we are telling that it is the hormone, that means it is released into blood from these G cells. And via blood, it travels and reaches to the fundus part of the stomach where the parietal cells are present. So let's see the details of this. See, actually the mucosa of the stomach dips little deep, and the opening of this dip in the mucosa on the lumen of the stomach is known as gastric pit. Okay, one thing before we proceed further, we have certain questions at the end of the video which are more clinically oriented, and we'll see that by understanding the physiology whether you are able to solve those questions or not, which I think that you will be definitely able to do. So let's continue. So now our gastric glands are present here. So some of these are mucus cells, there are stem cells, and there are G cells also here which secrete our gastrin. So what are these G cells? These G cells are flask shaped cells, and their apex is thrown into folds which we call as microvilli. So this apical portion of the cell is thrown into folds. So this forms the microvilli. So what happens, this exposes these G cells to the gastric contents. Now why it is important to know is that these G cells on their surface have certain receptors. So there are receptors for amino acids, there are receptors for peptides, there are also receptors for H plus ions. So these chemicals can act on the G cells and affect its function. So let us see what are the stimuli for the secretion of the gastrin from G cells. So as I already told that there are receptors for amino acids and peptides. And these basically stimulate the secretion of the gastrin from the G cells. Now once you understand the function of gastrin, you will realize that actually it's very important that these chemicals stimulate the secretion, because this G cell will release a gastrin, which in turn will cause the release of the HCl and pepsin in the stomach. And these are the ones which are important for the digestion of the peptides. So it's basically food is itself causing its own digestion by stimulating the release of the hormone. Okay, apart from that, what happens that when we eat, there is gastric distension, and this gastric distension causes the stimulation of the vagus nerve, causing release of gastrin releasing peptide. So there is again presence of receptors for this gastrin releasing peptide, which can act on G cell and stimulate the secretion of gastrin. So there are local stimuli, then there are neural stimuli. Plus, there are certain stimuli from blood as well. So this basal portion, which is near to the blood vessel, actually epinephrine, which is released from sympathetic neurons, and calcium, they can act on the G cells and cause release of the gastrin. So since the gastrin is important for the secretion of HCl, that is the reason that when there is a lot of stress and activation of the sympathetic activity, this epinephrine, you see, stimulates the secretion of the gastrin and HCl secretion. So stress can lead to increased acid secretion in stomach. Okay, so these are the stimuli for secretion of gastrin, local, neural, and some mediators from blood as well, we can say humoral. But these are all the stimuli for secretion. What we want is there should be some inhibitor of secretion also. So basically, as I told you, that H plus ions can also act on these G cells. So these H plus ions basically inhibit the secretion of gastrin from the G cells. So in short, let's see how the regulation of gastrin secretion occurs. So there can be multiple modes of stimulation of the G cell, which we said amino acids, peptides. Then due to gastric distension, there can be vagus, or from blood there can be epinephrine. So various stimuli can be present, which will ultimately lead to the secretion of the gastrin. Now this gastrin goes and acts on the parietal cells present on fundus. So there are certain receptors on these parietal cells known as CCKA receptors. Even though they are gastrin receptors, they are known as CCKA receptors. Now this causes release of hydrogen ions from the parietal cells into the gastric lumen, causing a change in the pH in the gastric lumen. Now it's important that when adequate pH is reached, it should not be like G cell continues secreting gastrin. So what happens that there is a negative feedback operating, that these H plus ions actually inhibit G cells from secreting the gastrin. So you see the end product is being fed back and it is inhibiting the secretion of gastrin from the G cell. There is another method also by which these hydrogen ions act. Basically, they cause increase of secretion from the D cells, which release somatostatin. And somatostatin acts on these G cells, causing the inhibition of the secretion. So we have seen that what are the stimulators of secretion of gastrin and what are the inhibitors. Now let's see what are the functions of gastrin. For remembering functions of any gastric hormones, there is some fundamental which you should remember. If you remember this, then I'm sure you will be able to actually guess the function of the hormone. So gastrin basically helps in digestion at the site where it is released and then moves the contents forward. It also maintains the site of secretion. Now if I ask you that what can gastrin do to help in digestion at the site? So obviously it should release the contents of the gastric juice, that is the HCl and pepsin. Then how will it move the contents forward? It will move the contents forward by increasing the GI motility. And this one, maintaining the site of secretion, that means it is trophic to the site of action, that is maintains its growth. So yes, these are the functions of the gastrin: stimulation of gastric acid and pepsin secretion, increase of gastric motility, and it is trophic to gastric mucosa, that is causes gastric mucosal growth. Okay, so based on this, let's solve certain questions. So your first question is, there are two statements given. First is the assertion, second is the reason, and you have to choose between the options. So assertion says that in pernicious anemia, there are elevated gastrin levels in blood. So you should know what is pernicious anemia. Actually, pernicious anemia is basically atrophic gastritis where there is a loss of the parietal cells. So if parietal cells are not there, what will happen is that hydrogen ions will not be released. So first statement is, in pernicious anemia there are elevated gastrin levels in blood, and second statement says that negative feedback inhibition of gastrin secretion does not occur in pernicious anemia. So what is your answer? The answer here is first one. Both A and R are true, and R is correct explanation for A. Why? Now you see that pernicious anemia, I told that there is loss of the parietal cells. So if parietal cells are not there, hydrogen ions will not be produced. And if hydrogen ions will not be produced, we said that these hydrogen ions are having a negative feedback inhibition on G cells. So if hydrogen ions are lost, the negative feedback on the G cells is lost, causing increase in the levels of the gastrin. So yes, first statement is correct. In pernicious anemia, definitely there are elevated gastrin levels in blood, which is known as hypergastrinemia. And what is the cause of that? The second one, negative feedback inhibition of gastrin secretion does not occur. So that's what our question is saying. Both A and R are true, and R is correct explanation for A. Okay, let's go to second question. Second question says that administration of proton pump inhibitors. Proton pump is basically hydrogen potassium ATPase, which is present on the parietal cells and is responsible for the release of the HCl. So if we give proton pump inhibitors for 2 months, that means we are blocking the production of HCl, it can cause rebound increase in gastric acid secretion when the drug is stopped. Now it looks very complicated, and here we are asking that whether this statement is true or false. Now, this is used clinically actually. If you see that a patient who is given proton pump inhibitors for 2 months, we generally see a rebound increase in gastric acid secretion when the drug is stopped. Why is this occurring? See, when HCl is not produced, this proton pump inhibitor is actually a very powerful drug and it blocks this hydrogen potassium ATPase kind of completely. So HCl is not produced at all. Then what happens? Obviously, there is increased gastrin levels, as I told you before, that if HCl is not there, negative feedback is lost and it will cause increased gastrin levels. Now you see the functions of gastrin. One of the functions of gastrin is that it is trophic to gastric mucosa. That means if there are high levels of gastrin, it will cause hyperplasia in the stomach. So what happens that whatever cells are there, they proliferate. So obviously the mucosal growth is occurring. So this gastrin, whatever gastrin is there, it acts on increased number of parietal cells. Getting the point? So it's a little roundabout answer. So because of proton pump inhibitors, gastrin has caused growth of the gastric mucosa. What we call is that it is trophic. And later on, normal levels of gastrin are acting on increased number of parietal cells, causing increase in gastric acid secretion. So, and this is used in practice actually, this drug, if it is used for 1 or 2 months actually, it should not be suddenly stopped. It should be either the dose should be decreased slowly, or when we are stopping the drug, we should switch to some other drug like H2 receptor blockers, which suppress the secretion of the gastric acid as well. So yes, this statement is true. Stopping the drug will cause increase in gastric acid secretion. And I have explained you why this is true. Okay, before finishing, let's come to question number 3. Gastrinoma is a gastrin secreting tumor. Sorry, this spelling is wrong. It should be tumor. And the secretin stimulates the secretion of gastrin from gastrinoma. Again, let us see whether it's correct or not. Yes, gastrinoma is a gastrin secretin tumor, and a tumor which causes hypergastrinemia, we call it as Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. The plethora of symptoms which occur, we call it as Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. Now the secretin, which we did not see till now, what happens? The secretin is released from intestine, that we'll see in the video on secretin. Actually, this secretin also inhibits the secretion of gastrin from the G cells. See, secretin is released from intestine and its main function is to maintain pH in the intestine. So if lot of acid is being secreted, acid enters into the intestine as well. So this secretin basically neutralizes that acid in the intestine and also decreases the production of acid in stomach. Anyways, the question says that secretin stimulates the secretion of gastrin from gastrinoma. So yes, what we have discussed physiologically actually, secretin inhibits the secretion of gastrin from G cells. But when it comes to gastrinoma, secretin actually stimulates the secretion of gastrin from gastrinoma, and these gastrinomas mostly these are present in pancreas. So this is known as secretin stimulation test. So you see here both the statements are true. Gastrinoma, yes, it is a gastrin secretion tumor. Secretin does stimulate the secretion of gastrin from gastrinoma, though physiologically it actually inhibits the secretion from G cells. Okay, so in this case, answer is both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation for A because these are two correct statements which don't have any relationship to each other as far as reasoning is concerned. Okay, that's all for the hormone gastrin for now. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, do press the like button, share the video with others, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel Physiology Open. Thank you.